What's up, gangsters? It's one of those days where I am tired and it's a quiet day, so I thought might as well do a quick video review that I've just been neglecting. And this one is kind of a book review. I have been trying to work on my figure painting skills, and so in that effort, I dropped some coin for a stack of books, magazines, whatever you want to call them, from Mr. Black Publications. And they're super cool, and I thought you guys might want to take a look as well. So let's check them out. Okay, so here we go. I'm going to whiz through this pretty quickly and not try and show you each and every page. And I don't think I'll have to for you to get the idea of exactly how nice these books are. The work that's featured in them is really just astonishing in how beautiful it is and how well done it is. And the books themselves are really well done. You can see they're printed on this nice heavy-duty matte paper and just have a real nice feel to it. The quality of the photography is excellent. One beef that I have with a lot of these publications that purport to be how-to or step-by-step is that the photography is just not really that good or close enough or broken down into enough steps to really tell you everything that you need to know. And these are not perfect. There's quite a few articles where I wish that there were more steps included, but they really are pretty good overall. And let's just take a quick look at this one. This one is one in particular that I wanted, and I forget how many of them there are. You can see this one's number 12. There are a bunch of them, and most of them are just step-by-step figure painting. There are a couple of them, like this one in particular, which is the World War II special. And I think there's three of these now, where they get into a little bit more with dioramas. But for the most part, these Mr. Black books are all about really high-end figure painting. I mean, the kind of stuff that you see on the front of this Young Miniatures box. And this is the bust that I have that I'm just getting into, which you can see. I've already done my black priming and my white highlighting to give me a little bit of a map for the lights and the darks. But anyway, it's a really nice figure, and I want to do a good job, so I felt like these books would be a good way to try and learn some more. And they have. I've picked up on some things. They're not going to give you a formula necessarily for how to paint something so that it looks this good. I mean, listen, that comes down to world-class talent and artistic vision right there. But they definitely will help. You can see, like in this case, really nice full-page figures, a little bit of text about what's going on, and then lots of pictures about how it goes, how the piece goes from beginning until end. It's kind of funny. My camera is trying to do face recognition on each one of these pictures. The technology is just that good. Anyway, so you can see, I mean, this figure is a, let's see, 120 millimeter, which is 1/16. So this is a pretty good size figure. So you'd expect to see an amazing level of quality for something that large. But let me look at the leather in the jacket here. Just phenomenal. The tones, the obvious technique control, it's just really, really good stuff. It's pretty intimidating because, you know, obviously I want my bust of this U.S. Army Air Force pilot to look good, and I know I don't stand a chance of it being this good, but the one thing you can also be certain of is you'll never get there if you don't try and work at it. Now, this is one of the main reasons that I bought these, because you guys have heard me talk about Carlos Starton. He's one of my favorite dudes and literally one of the best model makers on the planet. And he has had several articles in these Mr. Black publications. And this is one of the bust pieces that he's done. He does his work a little bit differently than a lot of these guys. He uses an acrylic base like I've done on mine, and then uses oil paints for the most part, which is the method that I've adopted and which I've been using for the last couple of figures that I've done. It just makes more sense to me, and the blending with oils for me is much, much easier than trying to do it with water-based acrylics and trying to get the glazes right and all of that. So that's the approach I like. Some of these guys in here use enamels, which work in a lot the same way as oils do. And then some guys use a mix where they'll use acrylics for most everything, and then maybe use oils or enamels just for some of the shading. So you do get a pretty wide representation of the different techniques in figure painting. There's certainly more than one school of thought. One thing that is kind of, I don't know, it's kind of aggravating for me, challenging, and probably just because I just have some kind of mental block with it, but a lot of these articles go through these lists of colors with acrylics, because it seems like with acrylics, not only are there a lot more colors available, like I think the Vallejo model color line is over 200 different colors. And it takes a lot of those colors to get the variety in shading, because I guess they don't blend as well. So you can't work with, you know, like 10 basic shades like you can with oils. Anyway, a lot of these articles are just basically a litany of these colors. First, it was given a base coat of English Uniform 921 plus Black 950. There are no highlights, only wear and tear using different colors like Flat Earth 983, English Uniform 921, Sunny Skin Tone 845, Light Flesh 928. I mean, look, when I try to read that, I just get glassy-eyed, and I can't even keep track of it. And I guess that, you know, for you guys that paint with these acrylics, it probably becomes just like a second language to you, and you can read through something like this and see the colors in your head. But unless you've done that a lot, to me, it's just incomprehensible. I don't have any idea what the difference is between English Uniform 921 and English Uniform 956 or whatever. So it's kind of impossible for me to follow and doesn't do me a lot of good. But that is not really important, since I am doing what I'm doing with oils. And honestly, that's part of the reason why I went to oils, because I didn't want to have to buy 200 colors and try and figure out what each and every color number looked like. So anyway, that's just on me. But whatever you're into when it comes to figures, these books will give you a really good look at it. It seems like pretty much everything is from 1/35th scale up to, you know, like 1/10th scale busts like this. But, you know, overall, just really well produced and just beautifully done. This one's pretty cool. Anybody who's ever watched Game of Thrones obviously is going to recognize that. And it's pretty cool. The one that I'm specifically focused on today, because I'm getting ready to start painting the face on my bust here, is this one. Because even though this one is really largely done in acrylics, I think, let's see, they do a good job of telling you at the beginning what kind of materials are used. So yeah, Joe Sanja Artists Acrylics. So even though these colors are not going to explicitly translate for me, what I'm going to try and follow is sort of this pattern of applying the different tones and blending them until I get to hopefully something that looks at least a little bit like this as a finished product. And another thing that I like about this series of publications is you get a feel for different styles. There are, you know, different schools of thought with figure painting. Some people feel like that they should be really high contrast in order to read correctly. you know, where they're almost caricatures or cartoonish. And then some people feel like they should have a much more realistic look. This is another one of Carlos's projects, just to show you he can do way more than just make figures. This thing is really cool. And Carlos has a really unique style. He paints a lot of emotion and character into his figures, and I love it. But my chosen path is something more like this, where it's got artistic beauty to it, but it has a little bit more of a realistic look. So anyway, I like the fact that different styles are well represented. Now, speaking of represented, this is one thing that I'm a little hesitant to bring up, because I'm sure it's going to create a little bit of angst for some of you guys. But there's one thing that I just can't help but notice. I bought 5 of these, and if you count the number of projects that are represented, there's 47 total projects. And if you do the math, right at 2/3 of them are Germans, almost all from World War II. Now, I know that's a subject of much discussion and argument in model making groups on Facebook and elsewhere on the internet. And I'm not going to get into trying to come up with the reasons, but, you know, the contention has been made that there is a great sort of overrepresentation of World War II German subjects. And look, although this is pretty unscientific, the data that I've collected here pretty much supports that. And I don't know what that is. I mean, you see it also with armor and with aircraft as well. There's just a great overrepresentation of German subjects. And there are lots of different reasons for why that, you know, people say that that's true. But my only point in bringing this up is that, I mean, I do find it a little bit weird. I'm not going to deny that. I get that there's a greater variety of uniforms and camouflage patterns and things that make it challenging to do German subjects. But I still just sort of find that such a great skew is just a little bit weird, especially when you look at the other 30% or so of projects that are represented in these 5 books and the distribution of subjects there, because they cover a wide variety of things, from medieval to you know, American soldiers in World War I, World War II, Japanese soldiers, everything. There is nothing that's got as much of a clear majority as the German stuff does. So anyway, I just felt like that was kind of something that was worth talking to. You know, don't yell at me, because A, I don't care, and B, it doesn't really do any good, because again, I'm not trying to ascribe motivations here. I'm just simply pointing out a phenomenon that I and others have noticed. Okay, so there you go. A quick look at some pretty cool books. I really think these are worth the money. They're not particularly cheap. I paid like $12 or $13 a piece. There's, you know, an exchange rate thing going on, because they're priced in euros. But Mr. Black Publications has a good website where you can see all the different volumes that are available. And there are other resellers, like Historex Agents, for example, who you can order these things from. But if you live anywhere outside of the UK, I believe you will pay a significant amount in shipping. But I got 4 of them, and Stelios, the really nice fellow who runs Mr. Black Publications, threw in a 5th one because I bought 4 and I was going to do a review. So I apologize for taking so long to get to it, but I'm a man of my word. I promised I'd do it, and here it is. So anyway, I hope you guys think these books are as cool as I do, and maybe you'll go check some out for yourself. All right, guys, as always, I appreciate you watching. Much love.